Very good afternoon, friends. And today we are on the day 7, lecture 7. So in today's discussion of the course Analog Electronics, we will continue with the discussion on small signal operations and models, okay, from module 1. So the learning objective for the session 7 or today's session is separating. We will see the focus of discussion would be on separating the signals and the DC quantities. And we will also introduce you to the hybrid pi model, okay, or hybrid model. So first let's see, let's discuss on separating the signal and the DC quantities, okay. As I said, the amplifier circuit is mainly composed of two components. One is the DC component and the AC components. Okay, so if we see, observe in the given or the analysis, if we discuss the analysis as indicated for the circuit diagram that is shown, it indicates that for every current and voltage in the amplifier circuit, we can have two components, or it consists of two components, the DC component and the signal component or the AC component. Say for instance, if we have VBE is equal to, okay, so you have the source here, so VBE is equal to VBE plus V small VE, okay? So one represents the DC component, the other represents the signal component. And similarly, IC can be represented as IC plus capital IC, okay? Capital IC plus small IC, and so on. So the DC component are determined from the DC circuit, and we also see the relationship imposed by the transistor, okay? So the DC, so we can see a representation of the signal operation of the BJT can be obtained by eliminating the DC sources, okay? And since the voltage of an ideal DC supply does not change the signal voltage across it, okay? The voltage of an ideal DC supply does not change, the signal voltage across it will be zero. On the other hand, representation of the signal operation of the BJT can be obtained by eliminating the DC source, as I said. And if we observe, since the voltage of an ideal DC supply does not change, the signal voltage across it will be zero. And for this reason, we can replace, okay? We can replace VCC by VBE, okay? We can replace VCC by VBE and with a short, replace by VBE and with a short circuit. And the circuit contained ideal DC current source. These would have been replaced by an open circuit. And the circuit is, however, useful only insofar as it shows that various signal currents and voltages. It is not an actual amplifier circuit. And since the DC bias circuit is not shown, okay? And we can also see that the expressions for the current increments, okay, so you can see for IB is equal to VBE by R pi, and IC is equal to GM VBE, and IE is equal to VBE by RE, okay, and obtained, so all these are obtained when a small signal, okay, so these are obtained when a small signal VBE is applied, and these relationships can be represented by the circuit, and such a circuit should have three terminals, the collector, okay, the base and the emitter, and should yield the same terminal current indicated here, resulting, and the resulting circuit is then equivalent to a transistor so far as a small signal operation is concerned, and thus it is can be con considered as an equivalent small signal circuit model. Okay, so if we have to say we are replacing VCC by VBE with a short circuit, and if the circuit contains an ideal DC current source, then we replace the same by open circuit. Okay, so the expressions, as I said, and it should yield the same terminal current as indicated here, okay, in this figure. IC is GM VBE, IB is VBE by RPi, and IE is VBE by RE. So the resulting circuit is then equivalent to the transistor so far as the small signal operation is concerned, and thus it can be considered as the equivalent small signal circuit model. And now let's see how we are modeling these circuits, or BJT transistor modeling is done. So model, when we say a model, model is an equivalent circuit that represents the AC characteristics of the transistor. So model is used, or it uses a circuit element that approximate the behavior of a transistor. And there are two types of commonly used small signal AC analysis for a transistor. The first one is the RE model, and the second one is the hybrid equivalent model at high frequency. And here we are using the H parameters are constant, and it becomes complex in nature. Okay, for a hybrid equivalent model at high frequency, since we are talking about, we are dealing with high frequency, the H parameters are not constant, and it becomes complex in nature, and therefore hybrid pi model is used for high frequencies, and this gives a reasonable compromise between accuracy and simplicity to do high frequency analysis of the transistor. Okay, so now let's see the equivalent model using the hybrid model, and before that let's see the advantages of hybrid pi model. The advantages of hybrid pi model is that audio frequencies, the high H parameters are real numbers, which makes computation easy, and these parameters can be easily determined from the transistor static characteristics curve, and they are convenient to use in circuit analysis and designing. And most of the transistors manufactured specific H parameters. So once the H parameters are graphically obtained for one configuration, the H parameters are obtained by a simple conversions. So if now let's see the hybrid pi model. So the figure that you see represents or is an equivalent circuit model for a BJT. And BJT has a voltage controlled current source. The circuit shown is for a voltage controlled. As I said, it can be BJT can be modeled as a voltage controlled current source, or it can also be modeled as a current controlled current source, right? So here what we are showing is a voltage, BJT has a voltage controlled current source, and explicitly it includes the input resistance looking into the base. Okay, so if you are looking into the base, then you have RPi. Okay, so the model is IC is equal to GM VBE, or IB is equal to VBE by RPi. Okay, so at the emitter, obviously, however, it is the fact that the model also yields the correct expression for IE, and this can be shown, or at the emitter node we have. So at the emitter node we will have IE is equal to IC plus IB, right? IC plus IB, and where if you substitute for IC and IB, we get VBE by RPi plus GM into VBE. So this is equal to VBE. Okay, so if I'm taking out the common VBE by RPi term, okay, so VBE by RPi is equal into, so you have 1 plus GM into RPi, right? Okay, so IE is equal to VBE divided by RPi into, I can express this as 1 plus GM RPi as 1 plus beta. So this is equal to VBE divided by RPi, taking this term, okay, as 1 over 1 by 1 plus beta. So it becomes IE will be equal to VBE divided by R pi divided by 1 plus beta. So an equivalent circuit model can also be expressed as, okay, so this can also be expressed in terms of, as I said, as a current control current source. Okay, so when you're expressing it as a current control current source, I can express GM VBE as GM IB R pi. Okay, VBE is nothing but IB into R pi, right? So in terms of the base current, this can be written as GM R pi IB, or this can also be rewritten as beta into IB. Okay, so here the transistor is represented as a current controlled current source with the control current being IB here. Okay, so it is very important to note that the small signal equivalent circuit models model the operation of BJT at a given bias point. And this should be obvious for the fact that the model parameters GM, R pi, and R naught depends on the values of the DC bias current IC, and the equivalent circuit model models the incremental operation of BJT around the bias point. Okay, and so this is about the hybrid pi model. Okay, so now let's do a small see some of the problems in the with regard to the theory that we discussed. Okay, so far, so the first problem is an NPN transistor having IS is equal to 10 power minus 15 and beta of 100 is connected, okay, as follows. Okay, the circuit is shown here in the next slide. The emitter is grounded. Okay, so please pay attention. The emitter is grounded. The base is fed with a constant current source supplying a DC current of 10 microamps, and a collector is connected to a 5 volt DC supply via a resistance RC of 3K. Assuming that the transistor is operating in the active mode, find VBE, okay, and VCE. Using these values to verify the active mode operation, replace the current source with a resistance connected from the base to a 5 volt DC supply. What resistance value is needed to result in the same operating condition? Okay, so this is the problem. And since IB is known, and by expressing the collector current as, okay, we know that IC is equal to beta times IB, we can obtain the current controlled current source model. Okay, so we can determine, okay, we can determine VBE from an exponential characteristics of DB. Okay, so this is the circuit that is given. Okay, so you have IB to be 10 microamps, VCC is plus 5 volts, and then you have RC to be 3K, and then beta is, so you have, this is the given problem. And so we can represent this as a current control. So since IB is known, and we also express the current as beta times IB, we can obtain the current controlled we can obtain the current controlled current source model. Okay, so so we know that VBE is equal to VT. Okay, so this using this relationship of VBE is equal to VT log IB by IS by beta. Okay, so substituting for VT IB IS and beta, we can obtain the value of VBE. Okay, so VBE is 25 log n 10 into 10 power minus 6 by 10 power minus 17, which is equal to 690 millivolt. Okay, or say 0.69 volt. And then we know the relationship VCE can be expressed as VCC minus ICRC, right? So substituting And IC can be obtained from the expression beta IB. Okay, so you know the value of beta, you know the value of IB. So substituting that, you get IC to be 1 milliamp. Okay, so substituting for VCC is 5 volts, okay, as given in the circuit, and RC is 3, right? See, RC is 3K and this is plus 5 volts. So substituting that, 5 minus 3 into 1 milliamp. So this is equal to 2 volts. So VCE is equal to 2 volts. So since VCE is plus 2 volts is higher than VB, which is 0.69 volts, the transistor is indeed operating in the active mode. Okay, so now if you replace the 10 microamp current source with the resistance RB connected from the base to a 5 volt DC supply VCC, the value of RB must be, okay, so now we will calculate the value of RB. So RB can be established using the relation VCC minus VBE divided by IB, right? Using this expression, VCC is 5, VB is 0.69, and divided by IB is 10 microamps. So substituting these values, you get RB to be 431 kilo ohms. Okay, yeah, this is the solution. Now, next we'll move on to the second problem. So here the transistor of a certain type are specified to have beta values in the range of 50 to 150. Find the range of their alpha values. Okay, so here we'll have to use the relationship between alpha and beta. Okay, so we know alpha is related to beta as alpha is equal to beta divided by 1 plus beta. Okay, so beta range is given 50 and 150. So we need to find the value of alpha. So substituting beta to be 50 in the first case, you get 50 by 51 is 0.980. And for the second case, the beta is maximum value is 150. So alpha will be 150 divided by 151, which is 0.993. Okay. So this is the alpha. So alpha will range between 0.980 to 0.993. Okay. So that is the solution for the second problem. And now we'll move on to the third. So a BJT has having a beta of 100 is biased at a DC current, collector current of 1 milliamp. Find the values of GM, RE and RPi at the bias point. Okay. So we know the relationship between GM, IC and BT, right? So what is GM? GM is equal to IC divided by BT. Where we can calculate the thermal voltage as BT is equal to K into T divided by Q. Okay, so substituting the value for K, T and Q, we get K is 1.3806 into 10 power minus 23. We are considering ambient temperature or absolute temperature, which is 27 plus 273. That will yield you around 300. Okay, the temperature to be 300 in divided by 1.6. Q is equal to 1.062 into 10 power minus 19. Okay, so all these are standard values. So substituting that, we get VT to be 25.86. millivolt. Okay, and therefore your GM is equal to IC. IC is given as 1 milliamp, and therefore GM is equal to 1 milliamp divided by 25.86, which will yield you GM to be transconductance to be 38.66, that is approximately 40 milliamps per volt. And then you have RE to be, you need to find the resistor, emitter resistance. RE is nothing but 1 over GM. So 1 by 40 milliamp, that is approximately 25 ohms. Okay, and then RPi will be 1 plus beta times RE. So substituting for beta and RE, we get RPi to be 2.525 kilo ohms. Okay, so this is the solution for the third problem, and then we'll move to the next. So find the required collector feedback bias resistor for an emitter current of 1 milliamp. 1 milliamp, 4.7K collector load resistor and a transistor with beta is equal to 100. Find the collector voltage VC and it should be approximately midway between VCC and ground. Okay, so we know emitter current is 1 milliamp and for the collector, a load resistance of 4.7K is connected and the transistor has the beta value is to be 100. So you need to find the collector voltage VC and again it should be approximately midway between VCC and ground. So RB is equal to beta times VCC minus VBE by IE minus RC, that is equal to 100. So substituting for beta, VCC is 10 and VBE is 0.7. Okay. And IE is 1 milliamp. Okay. So substituting the values, we get 10 minus 0.7 divided by 1 milli minus 4.7K, which is equal to RB to be 460 kilo ohms. And then we have VC to be equal to VCC minus ICRC, that is equal to 10 minus 1 milliamp into 4.7K, that is equal to 5.3 volts. Okay, so this is the solution for the fourth problem. And then we have the next problem is to determine the Q point and find the maximum peak value of the base current for a linear operation, assume beta DC to be 200. So the circuit is given and we see that VBB is 10 volt, VCC is 20 volt, RB is 47 kilo ohms, RC is 330 ohms. Okay, so we need to determine the Q point. So if we have to determine the Q point, then we have to find out what is IC and IC sat and VCE sat. Those are the two points that you need to note down. Okay, this point of intersection. Okay, or this is a Q point. So we need to find out this. Okay, so first let's find out only beta DC of 200 is given. So IB is equal to VBB minus VBB minus VBE divided by RB. That is equal to 10 minus 0.7 divided by 47 kilo ohm. Okay, RB is taken here. And so IB is 198 microamps, that is equal to IBQ. Similarly, IC is equal to beta times IB. So we know what is IB and beta is also given. So it is substituting the value of beta and IB, we get ICQ to be 39.6 milliamp. And then VC is equal to VCC minus ICRC. So substituting VCC to be 20 volts and IC is 39.6 milliamp and RC is 330 ohms. So substituting that value, you get 20 minus 13.7 is equal to 6.93 volt. That is VCEQ. So IC sat will be VCC by RC. That is nothing but 20 divided by 330 ohms, which is equal to 60.6 milliamp. So IC peak is equal to IC sat, which is IC sat minus ICQ. Okay, so IC sat is 60.6 milliamp and ICQ is 39.6 milliamp. So your IC peak will be 21 milliamp. So subtracting IC sat with ICQ. Okay, you get 21 milliamp. Similarly, IB peak will be IC peak divided by beta, which is 21 milliamp divided by 200, which is 105 microamps. Okay. So your Q point or the Q point will occur or happens at ICQ and VCEQ, which is 39.6 and comma 6.93 also. So that is the value. And the maximum peak value of the base current is 105 microamps, which is ICP peak by beta. How do we find IC peak? IC peak is IC sat minus ICQ, which is 21 milliamps. Okay, so with this, we end the session 7, and let's continue our discussion in session 8. In session 8, we will be discussing on MOSFETs. Thank you. Let's meet for session 8 tomorrow.